here in person and watching on the live stream for taking the time out of your day to join us for this special celebration of 5 new hearing dog teams. I'm Katie Cremona. I'm an instructor here at the Southwest Region, and I've had the privilege of training these 5 dogs and these wonderful students for the past 10 days. Last Monday, which feels like a year ago, 5 strangers checked into our campus, apprehensive about what the future would hold. Which one of these rotating dogs would become theirs? Would it be a boy or a girl? Small or large? Black or yellow? After days filled with lectures, homework, handling, field trips, kibbling, wiping dog slobber off of our hands, and dusting hair off of our pants, you all sit in front of me as competent and capable trainers, waiting to begin your next chapter in your life with a hearing dog by your side. The Southwest region does not typically place hearing dogs, so some of you might be wondering what exactly they do. Our typical service dogs learn between 30 to 40 commands that are going to enhance the independence of their graduate. They must patiently wait for their handler to tell them how they can help. Hearing dogs are a whole different story. A hearing dog is tasked with only one job, but that job is crucial for their graduate. They are trained to alert their partner to sounds in the environment by very persistently nudging them with their nose. Once the handler has acknowledged their alert, they will bring them to the source of the sound. So these 5 dogs were chosen for our program based on their high work drive and their independent attitudes. Rather than waiting for their handler to give them direction, a hearing dog is working 100% of the time, scanning their environment and listening closely for specific sounds that they're trained to alert to. Their partner is not going to hear these sounds, so they have to make the decision on their own to disengage from whatever it is they're doing, whether they're rolling in the grass, playing with their favorite toy, or cozying in a deep sleep, to alert their partner to their sounds. Beyond these 2 physical tasks, a hearing dog is so much more, as you guys have all grown to know. I've only been working in the hearing department for a little under a year, but throughout my time interacting with clients, a common theme I've heard is that our clients feel that they are living in a world. Vivian has a lot to say to that. She says, I agree. Our clients commonly feel that they're living in a world of isolation. They feel anxious because they fear they might miss important sounds. They feel frustrated because they have to depend on someone else in order to feel comfortable in their day-to-day life. And in some cases, they have isolated themselves because from the outside, they don't have a visible disability. And many people don't understand their situation. Very distracting. Starting today, our graduates are going to enter the world with a well-behaved service dog by their side, attached to a bright orange leash with a patch on their vest that reads hearing dog. The world will no longer mistake these individuals for dismissing or ignoring them, but we'll see the team and understand that they might just need to take some extra time to communicate with that person. Graduates will watch their dog react to the world around them and provide them with visual cues to sounds in their environment, allowing them to confidently venture into the world, knowing they're not going to miss an important sound, like a smoke alarm, a police siren, or their keys dropping. There's so much to be gained by having a hearing dog. These graduates, all 5 of you who entered as strangers, leave campus today with not only a tool that would provide you with more independence, but with a best friend who's definitely going to provide you with endless laughter and unconditional love for the next decade. I'm proud of these 5 dogs, and I'm proud of their 5 new humans, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for you guys in the coming years, months. World War I. and today they're very popular throughout all branches of the military. Consistent with this tradition, Canine Companions honors each of our graduating veteran teams with our unique challenge coin. On one side is our logo and the phrase "proudly serving veterans since 1975. On the other side is an image of a dog with the phrase "one team, two heroes." Gerald served our country in the Air Force from the years 1964 through 1968 as a weapons loader. Gerald, it is my absolute honor to present you with this challenge coin today. Thank you for serving our country. And now I'm going to invite Amy Kinsella up to the front. Amy has spent the past 10 days with us helping to prepare our teams for this very day, all the while training her own string of first semester. We could not have done it without you, Amy. Hello, everybody. As Kate said, my name is Amy Kinsella, and I am an instructor here at our Southwest region, and I was lucky enough to be able to help out with this team training class. I also was tasked with the nearly impossible assignment of trying to put into words just what happened over the past 10 days. But before I get into that, I want to give a huge shout out to our incredibly talented and wonderful instructor, Kate Incremona. She is the one who trained these dogs, picked these people, orchestrated the matches, did all of the organizing of paperwork and schedules, and really was at the forefront of making this hearing dog team training class happen. So let's give a huge round of applause. So my job here was pretty much to show up, support, and I got to watch the magic unfold firsthand. I could not be happier that I was lucky enough to be a part of this hearing dog team training. As I look into the faces of the five individuals who will be receiving a hearing dog today, I am overcome with excitement for the adventure that you guys are about to embark on. These dogs are going to change your lives. I will never forget those first couple of days of class. Our sweet little hearing dogs are very dedicated workers, full of a little bit of extra spunk and energy. So as our graduates came out, trying to grasp the handling sequence, figuring out how to position their bodies, which words to use, when to kibble, trying to process everything that we're telling you guys to do, these dogs came out in full force. Full body wiggles, alerting their handlers to the sound, taking them to the source of the sound, back to the handler, back to the sound, back and forth, trying to figure out why it was taking these new people so long to figure out the game. These dogs love their job. Now that you guys, our graduates, know the game, you each are destined for greatness. To watch these dogs fluidly alert you to your cell phone ringing, a timer going off, door knocks, doorbells, keys dropping, someone calling your name, and to watch them do it with so much intention and so much enthusiasm has been so cool to see. We had a student come up to us this past week with tears in their eyes, saying that this dog is not only going to give them increased independence, but an overall increase in confidence. A confidence to get back out into the world. A confidence to interact again with others. A confidence to be braver. The physical tasks that these dogs are going to perform for you guys is incredible to see. But beyond that, there is no doubt in our mind that these dogs are going to provide you with so much companionship, so much laughter, love, and joy, and we could not be prouder of each and every single one of you. And now to our puppy raisers. We could not have done any of this without you guys. Raising a hearing dog is no easy task. They are full of personality, full of energy, and ready to take on whatever this world has to offer them. It may have seemed as though at times you are constantly trying to rein them in, but you guys stuck with them. You embrace them for exactly who they are. You loved them for it, and you allowed them to explore their world as it came. You guys prepared them for the role that they are now going to fulfill, stepping into the role of a hearing dog. So as these dogs walk across our stage today in their fancy new blue vests, I want you all to take a second to recognize what this means. For each dog walking across the stage, there is a puppy raiser that poured their heart and soul into this dog in hopes that one day they will go on to change the life of someone who they have never even met. For each dog walking across the stage today, there is a trainer, a donor, a volunteer, a group of people that made it all possible. And for each dog walking across the stage today, there is a graduate's life that will be forever changed for the better. It takes a village to see our mission here at Canine Companions come to fruition. And it goes without saying that the community, this family that we have built here is truly, truly remarkable. So now without further ado, I would like to introduce our December 2022 graduating class. I would like to introduce is Gerald from Renton, Washington. Gerald is being placed with service dog Dreamy, a female yellow lab golden cross. Dreamy is being presented by her puppy raiser, Carrie Moore of West Jordan, Utah. Woo! Introduce is Allison from Santa Cruz, California. Allison is being placed with service dog Capri the Fourth, a female black lab golden cross. Capri is being presented by her puppy raiser, Dennis Lewis from Boulder, Colorado. Puppy raisers, Mary Caldwell and Steve Weiss of La Quinta, California. going to hand it over to Maureen to be our class speaker.
Welcome, everyone. My name is Maureen McElroy. Is it working? Okay. My name is Maureen McElroy, and I'm thrilled to tell you I'm now a Canine Companions graduate. I was voluntold to be our class speaker, but actually, I'm quite honored to represent our class. My classmates and their partners have all been wonderful, interesting, kindred spirits, and I've been grateful to share this journey with them. Excuse me. Anyway, I'm supposed to tell you a little about myself. I have congenital nerve-related hearing loss that was first diagnosed in my early 20s. I struggled at work and with friends in social settings and keeping up with what was going on. I was almost fired once when I didn't acknowledge a supervisor's good morning. I didn't hear it. About age 30, I was fitted with my first hearing aids and was thrilled again to be among the hearing. But my hearing loss is progressive, and currently my age is, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm so easy. I'm sorry. Currently my hearing aids no longer bring me to normal hearing level. Hearing loss, as Kate mentioned, is isolating. Oh, I can't believe I'm so weepy. I'm sorry. What a terrible thing.
You're fine.
I'm going to take a minute.
We're fine, too.
You're not alone in that.
I didn't leave my practice, though. Hearing loss is isolating, frustrating, embarrassing, and fear-inducing. The wonderful thing about my classmates is they can relate. The wonderful thing about our instructors, Kate and Amy, was they taught us in a way we could all hear and understand and learn. The most surprising part of the Canine Companions training process was the connection and comfort level I felt with our instructors. You see, Amy, I don't see Kate. There we are. I have never attended a class where my hearing disability wasn't an uncomfortable embarrassment. I did not feel that with Kate nor Amy at all. They were clear, concise, organized, but most importantly, patient and kind when we didn't hear, didn't understand, or were lost. I was able to relax and actually learn. The most rewarding part has been, of course, the dogs. Beyond amazing. I've read and heard, and to a degree here on campus, I've seen the work that goes into these dogs. Work from the volunteer breeder caretakers to the volunteer puppy raisers, to the instructors and all the other folks involved. Their giant investment of love, time, patience, work, and money is awe-inspiring. From the bottom of my heart, thank you all. Your investment is mind-boggling and for me will be life-changing. My canine companion dog, Vivian the Fifth, is a smart, strong, beautiful, loving creature, and she and her ears and her eyes and her alerting nose will help keep me safely and actively functioning and enjoying life. The burden or worry of fear of not knowing if someone's knocking on my door, or not hearing a smoke alarm, or not hearing an emergency siren while driving, or not caring when someone's approaching from behind will be gone with Vivian beside me. Plus, I now have a new, loving, funny, smart, fun friend. Thank you, canine companions, and all the devoted volunteers and staff. Your love shows. Thank you.
Thank you, Maureen. Now we are going to turn our attention over, if there are not enough tears already, to our Meet the Graduates video that is an accumulation of pictures and videos that show you guys just all the hard work that went into the past 10 days.
Something to believe in. If you're looking for a light to guide you home, just look inside. Your light is shining brighter than you know. You should know I'm never gonna let you down. I'm always gonna build you up. When you're feeling lost, I will always find you love. I'm never gonna
I'm always gonna have your back, and if nothing else, and I live in Santa Cruz, California. And I have been paired with my hearing dog now. Her name is Capri, and she's a little black lab female. And Capri is so smart. And of course, I think she's the smartest out of all of them, because I just adore her. And then my other one is, the other thing I wanted to say is she is a strong personality dog, kind of like I am. And she's just a perfect match for me. My future hope to do with my hearing dog is, because she is service trained, I'd also like to get involved with the community more, and which I already am, and I have a lot of different organizations that I like to be around now that I'm retired. So I would like to provide some kind of services, probably volunteer work with the dog. And I'm really excited about it. And I just want to say that the team, all the team, the puppy raisers, the breeders, and especially the team here that works around here, they're wonderful people, and their heart is so full. I can feel it. And the trainers here are dynamite, and they're amazing. And they put out a great training course that really helped us to focus, learn how to be calm with your dog, and learn how to do the best for your dog, how to take care of your dog. There's so much to learn here. It's just an amazing place, and thank you all for everything. This is just amazing. Thank you.
Second hearing dog, and I have to say this is going to be the best one. And we currently live in Palm Springs, California. And what I can say about the puppy raisers, they must be incredible people, because he's amazing. The one thing I like most about my dog is that he's intelligent, and he's very aware of what's going on in his surroundings, and he's very loving. I don't think you can get much better than that. And that all comes back to his early and later training. What I'm grateful for is I'm here, and we get another opportunity to have a hearing dog, and that allows me to not only know what's going on while I'm at home, but also when I'm outside of home. And I think that's the best of all worlds.
My name is Jim Ravishoni. I'm from Fresno, California. This is Zoe, my new hearing dog. When I got her and finished this class, I realized I had gotten back confidence, I would say, in myself that I'd lost with my hearing, along with my hearing loss. She's given me the confidence to do things I would never thought of a week ago. She's a great dog. And I just feel like I can go anywhere and do anything with her help. When I was matched with Zoe, I was thrilled with her. She'd been so easy, so well trained. It was just amazing, the relationship we developed. I just can't thank everyone involved enough for what they've done. The work and time spent and the dogs for us. Thank you.
afternoon. My name is Maureen McElroy, and I'm hoping to be a graduate of Canine and Companions for Indian. My second question is, I wanted an assistance dog because as I'm getting a bit older, not hugely old, but a bit older, I'm beginning to see the need for another tool in my hearing loss tool belt to allow me to safely and happily navigate and engage. What better way to improve my life than by having this hearing dog assistance in the form of a furry, loving friend? I want to say thank you so much to CCI. About almost 3 years ago, I was investigating having a hearing dog or how to get a hearing dog, and I came across CCI on the internet, and I couldn't believe what they were offering. It was phenomenal. Fifi, sit. Good girl. Down. Down. Good girl. The training and resources they put into these animals, from the breeders to the puppy trainers, God bless you puppy trainers, to the 6 month kind of final polishing trainers here at CCI, I appreciate so much all the time and love and energy and expertise and professionalism you put into that. Thank you very much. Thank you also to Kate and to Amy, who've been awesome trainers, who've been patient with us. We 5 students who can't hear and sometimes get mixed up. And thank you also to Vivian, my new friend. Appreciate it.
Hi, I'm Gerald Severance. I'm from Renton, Washington. This is my new hearing dog, Dreamy. Team training has been excellent. The entire staff that I've worked with are really outstanding. I could not have done this without a lot of family support, friend support, and the people here at Canine Companions working with me. So there's the staff here, there's the puppy raisers, the whole program administrators have all been wonderful.
Again, both here today and anyone on the live stream watching. You truly understand the meaning of love and selflessness, and I extend my gratitude to your dedication to our mission and to these dogs that are being very adorable right now. One last thank you to everyone for sharing this day with us and for welcoming our newest members to the Canine Companions family. If you've seen something today online that has touched you, visit our website at canine.org. We hope to see you again in the future. Graduates, it has been an absolute honor to get to know all of you and to be a part of your journey. Each of you guys has touched me in a very unique way, and I'm very appreciative of the trust that you've put in me to match you with dogs that are going to be by your side for the next decade. This is my final time to say release to you, send you on your way to begin your life with new ears by your side. We wish you the best. Keep in touch. Congratulations.
I'm sorry.